Okay, so we've got them all sized, at least in thickness and in width. Now we can start doing some length cutting. I'm going to hold off on this block until things are sort of together, because this thing's got to be fitting between two other bits, so we'll just leave it until everything else is in place, so that center block is... It's a minor piece that is easy to get done later. It's easier to do later, so... So I've just got a bunch of these pieces to cut to length, and I'm just going to start by finding them on the material, finding them on the plans, I should say, and then I will mark them and just cut them to length here in the vise, and then we can do the radiusing. And as far as length goes, I'm kind of, sort of... I'm going to leave a little bit, but not a ton. So what we'll do is just grab a sharp pencil, and I'll just make a small mark. I'll just line up one end. The cool thing is that this doesn't have to be anywhere near precise. I should say it has to be sort of precise, but it doesn't have to be terribly precise, because whatever's extra I can cut off with a chisel after they've been scalloped. So we'll just stick that one in ye olde vise. I don't have to cut it square. I have really very little concern here, even with chip out and whatnot. It's not a major concern about how careful we are with this cut, because these are going to get scalloped and shaped quite a lot, and I'm going to keep these little blocks because they can come in handy for other parts of the guitar. So that was B3. So now we have B3 cut to length. Do B4 now. I don't know why I did B3 first, but it doesn't matter. And these things are, I have no idea what the lengths are, and I don't need to know what the lengths are. I just need them to be, you know, according to the plan. Everything else is sizing nicely to scale here, so I'm not really too concerned about being short or anything. So we'll just take another slice here. Hang on to those pieces. Alright, cut to length. Now, I think we can set about doing the radiusing on these things. I just got a message from Gabriel, who had talked about doming the top yesterday. So yesterday, the first part of this guitar build video posted, so it gives you an idea of how far into the future we are. That video he commented on about this arching, and today I just happened to be right at that decision point where I can make my mind up on whether I'm going to do the arching the top or not. I literally just have all the bracing done, so we're right there. So if I'm going to change, now's the time to decide whether or not I'm going to change or deviate from the plans. Basically what it comes down to is the fretboard is at an angle this way relative to the top surface, so that you get enough height at the bridge so that the strings are up high enough at the bridge. Some guitars, the top surface is done completely flat, and you can see, I think you can see right in here, you see down in there that there's a pretty sizable amount of space there, 2 millimeters, millimeter and a half, that this would end up being pressed down, and you end up with this weird bend in the fretboard, which is not good. So the radiusing is an attempt to put some support up here. The way Gabriel suggested is at about the sound hole, you go flat, but at the sound hole down, you simulate this angle again. You just do a flat angle, and it puts kind of a small tweak here, and then the rest of this is all still flat. Gabriel has built many guitars. Him and his dad have done a fantastic job of documenting their experience on their website. You definitely should check it out. There's a link here, and there's one down in the description. You got to check out Gabriel's stuff. He does Hoffman guitars. He does an incredible amount of good for the community and for the furthering of this craft. He's doing a wonderful service for the craft, and I'm a fan of that. I am so grateful that Gabriel shows up on day one of the build and gives me fantastic advice. I will follow that advice one day. Maybe not on this guitar, but I will follow other advice that he gives. It's always wonderful to hear other methods of doing things. Essentially, it comes down to confidence and comfort level, and I just have to pick one and get some education, and that's what I'm doing. I'm paying those dues right now. I'm trying stuff, and there's going to be a lot of wise people who say or give fantastic, solid, foundational, firm, tried and true advice that I may not follow, not because I disagree with them, but I just don't know enough to feel confident in following it. Some of this has to do with just knowing whether I can recover from something. I just also realized that I cut my sides already, and so I sort of am, I could fix that, I think I could tweak it, but I've already cut my sides to their shape, so I'm sort of locked into that arc, that arching of the top anyway. So, a lot of talking about it, but I'm going to stick with arching the top. Remembering that I already cut the sides has already tied it, has sort of driven it for me. I will eventually, someday, I will venture out. But if you know anything from watching my videos, I do not rush into much. like picking a color. Sorry. You can rest assured I will be I'm not going to say zero color touching on this one, but a lot less. I don't have a color in mind that we have to find, so you're going to be spared from color testing. I promise you that. Anywho, let's get set up to radius all of these guys. The back is radiused at 15 feet. The top is radiused at 25 feet. And I cut something earlier, a couple of weeks ago, to help me radius these guys. And so we'll bring you back when I'm ready to do that. So this is just a little jig for radiusing. So you can sort of see it's kind of tough. It's not the easiest to see, but there's a dish here. It's radiused at this diameter, or at this radius. At this radius. So there's that, and then there's this one here. So these coincide with the radii of the front and the back. So what I'll do is take a little bit of sticky back sandpaper here. This is 150, because I'm kind of going for smooth, but also not super slow. And we'll just stick this down into there might be some adhesion trouble here with this particular. No, we're good now. And we'll just stick this down. We're going to do the fronts first, since that's the 25 foot. I'm just going to stick it down. I'm worrying about cutting into the jig, but I need to stop caring about that. Doesn't matter that much. Okay. There is that. So now, got ourselves some abrasive. Now, is stuck down pretty good. I need this side to stick a little bit better. Here. Just press on it a little better. Now, all we have to do is take our piece. Let's do T6. and radius this edge so that when it goes down, the back, or the front in this case, will sit on it. So we just, at this moment, are picking our top and back, our top and bottom of these. And I don't think this is going to take enough off to fix this little ding on this side. So I'm going to do it on this side. I'm looking at the grain direction too to make it, make sure I'm doing something easy to cut with. So anyways, so take this side and we're just going to put it on here and sand until the center is touching. Well, how do you do that? How's the easiest way to do that? In this case, I'll just mark a spot roughly in the middle with some pencil. So now that if the pencil's gone, we're done. So it's literally that simple. And just take this and the big thing is not to press down real hard because you'll flex it and you don't want to flex it. So maybe 150 was a little bit too fine. It's going to take a little while, but I also want it smooth. So I'm just going along here. Also being careful to keep it basically vertical as well. You don't want to tip it too much. And every once in a while, I'm just going to flip it around because it'll help keep me accurate and even. Okay, we're getting, well, we got about a 16th yet to go. So it might have been okay to do on that side. It's all right. And we literally just get after this until that pencil mark is gone. Once that's gone, we know we're done. I may go to a coarser grit just to make it go a little quicker here, but this truly is all that it takes. I need to watch my tip here, make sure I'm not tilting. I'm leaning this way a little tiny bit, so just going to put a little pressure this direction so that it presses more that way. Try to stand us back up the right way. And just keep it vertical. And I'm truly not pushing down at all. See, I still got pencil. I'll try to get you some better shots of this here while it goes, because I've got a few to do. And it truly is this slope. It's, I'd rather sneak up on it than overshoot. Now, in theory, I could be pushing here because they're already touching. And I think I will do that now. That way I'm not flexing in the center anytime at all. We're getting close-ish. No, we're not really hitting that at all yet. No, we just keep going. Haven't hit it yet, so still going. Have we hit any pencil yet? Not yet. We're still getting there. It's almost. I think we're getting really close here now. We are almost there. If I were pressing in the middle, it would probably be touching right now. Getting there. Starting to touch anywhere yet? Not yet. Now we're starting to touch. Okay. Let's double check our squareness here. How long is that? See, we're already cutting on to the, taking the pencil off now, so I'm almost done. Just now is my chance to get any squareness issues taken care of. I think we're good. This is two or three strokes away here. Almost. Yeah, it's almost there. I would say that's it. Okay, so we got one done. What did that take? 7 minutes. With explanation, more like 5 minutes. So 5 minutes apiece, now we have our radius. Now, while I've got it like this, I'm gonna mark my top as my up. So that way I know that's the radius side. I can tell now it's curved enough though. I just wanna be certain that it's not messed up. So there's one. We're gonna do the rest of these here and I'll bring you back. Okay, with everything radiused, probably didn't need to radius the tiny things, but that's okay, we did it. So first thing we're going to do now, or the next thing we'll do, is get the cross, the X, we'll get that worked out. So this is T6, and it's a half lap joint at a diagonal. And so what I'm going to do is put it on the full scale drawing here and use that as my guide. Boy, those radiuses came out perfect. Very nice, very nice. So what I will do is I got to work out it's a half lap, so it's a cross lap. So it's notching on the bottom of this one and the top of this one to get them together. And so I need to mark them so that I can cut them. I want to use my marking knife, so I'm going to grab that real fast. Okay, so what I will do is take a pencil first, because it's a cross lap, so we got to cut it on a diagonal. So I have to mark it in two different locations, one on either side. And so I'm just, to get my brain around it properly, we're going to mark the bottom of this one pretty close to where it'll go. You can take a little bit more of that for that side. Yeah, that'll work. And I'm just putting it against the drawing and I'm marking. This is very rough and I will come back in a second, but I just want to make sure I mark it while it doesn't move, so that I'm in the right vicinity, and then I can come over here. I can mark, wrap these around to the bottom side. Okay, now I see where my lines are supposed to be. This tells me which of these lines. It's really tough for you to see that, but let's see if I can get you a shot of that. Hold on. Okay, really quick first, just to illustrate what's going on here. This piece is T6. And it goes here, about like that. T5 has to cross it, about like this. T5 actually goes down first, like this, and you can tell with the radiusing in it, we're rocking a little bit, which is perfectly fine. And then T6 will go here, so we have to let them into each other. And they are marked here. These drawings are these braces here, showing exactly where the features need to be. And so if you can see, and I'll bring in a little bit more, I need to mark a diagonal notch in this one and a diagonal notch in this one so that they can set together. And the dimensions are marked here on the plans, but I need to make sure I get them. I'm trying to make sure I get my head in the right place, and I'll show you here what's going on. Okay, so now you can see here T6 is the top one. This one comes in last, or on the top. This is T5. T5 gets a notch on this side. T6, let's make sure I'm on the right. Yep, T6. Yep. T6 gets a notch on the bottom side. So what we got to do is make sure that it's diagonal. So you can see here there's two sets of lines. One is for this side, and one is for this side. One set is for this side, and one set is for this side. So we actually cut a diagonal across. So what I've done first is I went over to the main pattern, put it roughly in place, the main that shows them assembled, and just put a couple of ticks, a couple of pencil marks here. And then I can line up here, end to end on this drawing part, and now I can see where my, roughly where my pencil lines are where I need to tell me which of these sets of which pairs go on which side is what I'm doing. Then I can flip it over. So I'm going to bring you down low and you can see what I'm doing here. All right, here's a better view. So you got your two sets of lines, and on the other side I put a mark so where they cross. You've got this pencil line, set of pencil lines here, and then on the reverse side, this set of pencil lines. And I carried them over and you can see they're misaligned. Well, they coincide with these lines. So what I do is line up one end on the rest of the plan, and now I can see that this side uses the left two lines, and I can use that to mark exactly where I need to place these guys. And now the trick is that I need to make sure I line up sort of centered between these two so that they get the angles correct. Then I'm going to come in here and use my, that's going to get right in your way, isn't it? I'm going to use my marking knife right on that pencil, or not on the pencil line, but on the mark on the paper, and do the same. I'm going to flip my marking knife around and try to hold on to it stiffly, like so. We moved a bit. I'm going to get back into where it goes. There we go. Okay, and then I flip it end for end. No, sorry. I flip it this way. Yeah. We flip it this way. And I do the same thing on the other side. And I apologize in advance. That's going to be difficult for you to see, but just believe that it is what I'm doing here. And I just want the other side lines to line up. And all I'm doing is making marks so that I know where I need to cut. And then I'll show you here. See if I can get the, see the lines there, the little ticks? There you go. Now you can. So there's the set of ticks here and on this side over here. Now all I've got to do is connect them. And I'll pull back and I'll show you that. Okay, so I've got my little tick marks. I'm going to take my tiny little rule here, and I'm just going to put my marking knife up against it. I'm going to put it into one notch first, and stick the ruler on it, and make the mark. Oh, that went too far on that side. So we're just going to connect these two lines like that. And I'll just slice nicely here. Okay, and then we'll do the same to this side, and they'll be parallel, or should be parallel anyway. And we'll connect this one here with that one there. And they should be pretty darn near parallel now. Okay. Now all we need is a depth, and I'm going to use my small square here, this little guy, and I'm just going to gauge that depth. We're actually going to grab the metric ruler here real quick and get a sense of where that should be. That is 8. It's right on the 8 millimeter mark, so we're just going to slide to 8 millimeters here and just do it like this. And then a little less than 8 so that I force it to be trimmed right. And so this is radiused, so what we're doing is kind of an approximation anyway. And so I'm just going to put a pencil mark here. I'm actually going to, yeah, we'll just do that. And then I'll put a straight line down here for the, I'm just going to mark this one with a pencil too. Actually going to make it a bit bigger first, and then I'll fill it in. And then I can fill the line in so I can see it better. And then we'll do this on this side as well. Go this way. Just do like that. There we go. Now I have a line I can get up to, and I can use it comfortably this way. Okay. Do the same thing on this side. Do the 8 millimeter mark first. That's our depth, and then we can come in here on the waist side here and go ba-dunk. And do the same to this side. It is easier to go this way, I think. There we go. And that lays out one half of the cross lap joint. We're going to do the other one too for the T5, but I'm not going to cut one until I'm actually going to just cut the one. And these should have enough room. Yep, that should fit it perfectly. Yep. Okay. So we're going to make the one cut, and we'll use this to cut the other side of the joint. That's how I'm going to do it. And so I'm just going to stick my thumb right where I don't want to be cutting, and I want to leave a little bit of opportunity for correction if I need it. There we go. Okay, just taking it easy. It's well within my marks. I'll be able to stick a chisel in there and really get it perfect. Yeah, we're way ahead of my line here. Okay, looks fine there, looks fine there. Just do the same on this side. Okay, that is enough of a cut. I'm going to grab a couple of chisels, and we're going to knock that waste out. Okay, just got a little, I think this is like a 3 millimeter chisel. It says it somewhere on here, I thought. Maybe not. 3 millimeters, about 3/16 wide. I'm just going to come in here and pop that out first. And then I can come in, flatten that bottom just a tiny bit. Fix this side here just a little. That was too much. There we go. And just take very little shavings here. Now I'm going to take my vertical plane here and get right up against my knife mark and take care of aligning with my knife line here. I actually think I might grab a larger chisel here. This one's about 1/4 inch wide. and use it to come across. I may also just move in the vise here a bit so that it's, there we go, that's good. Now, in theory, number 5 should fit right in here. It's pretty close. Yeah, that'll do. I'm going to leave it alone right here. That's good. It's a pretty snug joint, too. But I want to make sure I'm to depth. Sorry about that. I'm going to make sure we're to depth here. Just make sure I sever these fibers nicely here where I want to make sure it cuts. I may just do well to come a little closer to my vise here. Yeah, I think that'll work. This spruce cuts very nicely, I must say. Even though this chisel is not as sharp as it could be, it'll do. There we go. Okay, that one is good. Now I'm going to come back over to the plans and align everything so I can mark the other board. Okay, so we have this one we just cut. We're going to put the 5 down here. Right where it needs to go, right? Right. Yeah, right there is good. And then I'm going to put this one on there. Right like so, and I'm going to check this. I'm going to get everything aligned. Yeah, we're going for a little further up the chain here. Is that about right? That looks about right. I'm going to set it right there. That looks pretty dang good, actually. Yeah, right there is good, so I'm going to mark it with pencil first, and then I'll play around with that afterwards. So we're just making sure that I mark here, here, and here, and then a little bit on the underside. Make sure I mark this underside. That underside really doesn't matter. It's going to be adjusted here. But now we have our lines perfectly where we need to cut on the insides of these lines. And now we'll go back to the vise. Take our cross-cutting Japanese saw, and I want to stay well within my lines. I'm going to start very lightly, and then I'm going to check, make sure, and cut very carefully to depth. Yeah, that's not bad. Do the same on this side. Make sure we're within. We are. I think I'm going to get a smaller Japanese saw because I really like using them. But the big one can be a little unruly on these really delicate tasks here. So just take a little cut here, pull this waste out. Just peel this all out of here. This is a much sharper chisel than the quarter inch one was. Just take little bites, knock it all down. And then we'll get to a point where I can go across the grain here. Take the middle of this out. This stuff cuts so great. Do a quick little test fit here in a second. Looks pretty close now. Let's check our width here. Pull this guy on. Yep, that's pretty good. Our depth is actually really close. We're going to go about a 32nd, maybe less, deeper here. That's probably it right there. And it's okay if it bottoms out, or if it doesn't bottom out there. There we go. It's good on the bottom. That's where I care. I'm feeling under here because this is the side that's going to be glued up against the top. Yeah, that's pretty good. Let's go check that fit. Okay, so we'll just take it here. And it goes, which way does it go? It goes this side down. Something's wrong there. That doesn't seem. Seems I've got something wrong here. That's T5. Ah, okay, that's why. Goes like that. Ruh-roh, did I do this wrong? I think this is the downward side. Okay, oh, I see. Ha 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 ha. We go like this and like this. Got myself turned around there and scared me. Okay. Yeah, that's exactly right. Perfection. Scared myself pretty good though. That was nice. That's funny. Yeah, so we're just long enough. The cross is right where it should be. Everything extends just past the longest lines. Perfect. Okay. Our cross bracing is done there. Done there. Cool. That was loud as. Not as difficult as I was anticipating it being. Okay, so that part is done. I have to come up with my next steps. I think what I'll do is make the notches here, because these all have to get kind of mortised into, all of these little guys get mortised into the pieces. So yeah, that's what we'll do next. We'll get T9 and 10, T7, 8, 9, and 10, both 7s, 8s, 9, and 10, set to get kind of mortised into those ends, because 9, that one feathers to nothing out here, it's a little tall up here, so it's got to get let into the cross brace. So, yeah, we'll get set up for that next. Alright, so the first thing I'll do is on these cross braces. I'm going to go around the other side, hell. It's easier to reach that part of the plan this way. Let's take T9 here and we'll just get it aligned here-ish where the peaks of my... So I'm looking for these peaks of the scallops. Because I'm going to, before I glue them to the front or the top, I'm going to pre-scallop the ends so that I have a way to do this joinery for these things. So what you can't see is we've got that little guy right there. And do the same thing to this side. I'm just gonna get things right about in line, and we'll do this one as well. Those are my peaks, so I'm going to draw this one out to practically nothing. And this one I'm going to draw out to about 3 mil. Yeah, right about to that point. And so we're here. I'm going to draw this out to right about there. Now, I'm not going to cut that all the way right now, but I'm going to get it pretty close, especially down on the end, because I need to get it fitted into this sort of spot, basically, into this little notch. And I don't want to do that while this is glued down. I want to do the notch first and then have some way to check that fit. We're going to start with the thin guys, because why not, right? I'm just going to stick this in here, and I'm going to come at it with a nice chisel and just nibble away a little bit at a time until we get down to that 3 millimeter depth, which is where that line roughly is. Getting closer. Close, and that's about where I'm going to stop, right? One more, cut that square. There we go. Just like that, okay? And then I'm just going to waste a bit more of this out because it's none of it's necessary here. Okay. And do the same to the next one. We'll just keep on doing it. Just got the last of the skinnier ones here. Just bevel down, taking a slice, nothing to it. You guys can see, all right? Yep, you can. And just take tiny bites. You take too big a bite and it will tear on you, but if you take small bites, see, that one's too big, it tore. Luckily, I have a lot of room to play yet before I hit the final. So you see I'm bumping up against that line now. Now I'm just going to go real gentle along that line. And then I'm going to check that I'm pretty square. I'm going to take a little bit more off of this side. The lines are not in really precise locations either, so it's okay that we fudge it. Just rough a little more of this inner curve here. And that one's done too. Now we can move on to the bigger ones. So let's do T9, which is the thickest of them, T9. This one we can get pretty aggressive. You could saw this, but look at it, look at just how easy it is to come down on that. This cuts really easily. There's really no need to get in a big rush and come at it with a saw. You don't need a lot. Some guys, I did this, I think on my first acoustic, I did this on the belt sander. Took the cover off the top of the wheel, the top wheel. I'm gonna spin myself this way so I can work a little bit easier. And this method works fine too. The power tool method works okay if you're into it, but I find it a little fast. And that makes me a little nervous. I don't want to take too much off. See here, I'm trying to just sneak up, and I'm checking the end to make sure I don't take too much off of one side. There, I'll call that one close. I'm going to take a little bit more from the inside here and just get closer to these curves, though I don't need to do this. This is just a helpful, you know, saving some effort later, because we're going to come at this a little more later on with some small planes and stuff to really mess with these curves to get them really dialed in. But that's going to be enough for me to cut that joinery. That one's done. Do number T10 here. Okay, now that we've got those things shaped the way we want them. We've got all of these little guys. I'm gonna put one over here. One goes over here. One goes here. One goes here. These two. This one is 10, so this one goes here. And this one goes here. What I'm doing now is just making sure that I get a little bit under, but I want to make enough room. See, I've got these two have to intersect, basically. I just want to make sure there's enough room. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lop off this little corner here. Right like that. Because that'll give me something to put up against this part and mark for that cut. And then I'll do, basically this one's fine. This one's going in roughly at a 90 anyhow. This one we're going to leave a little bit. I'm going to take, let's see, where are we? Yeah, we're going to be about there with this one. And so we'll take just this corner off, roughly parallel with the axis. So that's very small. I'm going to go do this on the belt sander, and I'll show you that here real quick. Okay, so I said I was going to lop these corners off here on the belt sander. You think that's a pretty small cut, but I'm not going to use the belt sander quite the way you might think. I'm just going to move it by hand. Almost. I'm going to fix that just a little. And now you can see I took the line, or split the line, basically. Focus, you fack. Anyway, pretty good there. That's all it takes to really get that shaped right. Do the other one here real quick. All right, so now the next little bit is we're going to put these guys back into place. And I'm going to get them as close to accurate alignment as I can here. They really mostly go into this one, but I want to make sure we're everybody's as accurate as they can be here. So there's this piece here, and then I can just press it down like that and just get it positioned there. This 9, what is this one? This one's 9. This one goes right here, and I can mark for it. Just do this and this. I want to make sure we stay pretty accurate there if I can. Get in there. Get in there. And get in there. Like that. Okay. And then I'm going to do the same right down here. Nothing's shifting too badly. It looks like it's moving around a lot, but I'm watching my lines, making sure things don't move around where they shouldn't. Just take these two and set them down like so, like a dit. And grab a sharper pencil here, just like so. And get down in here. Like that, and I'm going to leave a little bit of room so I don't F myself. So we're going to take this one. I'm going to worry about the other ones in a minute. But I'm going to take this over to the vise, and we're going to cut those. All right, so now we've got T10, and this is where T10 goes, okay? What I'm doing is I've got the mark since I've trimmed the corner of this. Now I have a good registration mark if I get rid of the burr that's on this thing. I'll take that over here real fast. There we go. Okay, so I've got this little burr, or this little angle that I can use to tell it, to tell myself, you just put it in place, and now I can see where my pencils are way over there, where my mortise has to be for this and what angle. So we're just going to draw a couple of lines that are parallel with this line. And here. Okay. And I'm going to treat this kind of like you do a half blind dovetail. So I'm going to cut it with the saw, but I'm not going to cut all the way. I'm only going to cut a tiny bit of this. Let's take, I might want to grab a lighter saw here, but let's see. So line up with my angles. Yeah, I'm going to get a finer saw. I'm just going to use my flush cut saw here. Hold on a minute. Just need some finer teeth is all. That saw is a little bit much for that. And just come over here now. Line up perfect with that. And we just cut down at an angle till we've reached our depth. And not go too far in to either side. I want to stop the curve from going too far on either side. Mostly I care on this face because it's technically kind of visible. Okay, now we can come back at it with these nice little skinny chisels and just take out the middle waste to very near our lines, which are right there-ish. Oop. And you want to make sure you're careful about making your relief cuts and such. Do the same this way. Okay. And like so, kind of like that. But as you can see, this one is done. You see there? I'll show you the part going into it here. Doink. Eh? Just like that. So that's all we're doing. Let's do that for this one. Alright, now that the bracing is basically shaped, I'm actually ready. I can't glue it on yet because I need to do some things to the top, but I'm actually ready to do those things to the top. Yeah! Flinging stuff. So, here's a problem though. I've got my top, right? And I've got a template for my top. Over here. And I've even worked up a workboard for it. But problem is, I don't have, right now, a circle cutting jig for my Bosch Colt, for my router. So, in order to do this, before these go on, because that's going to make the top all curved, right? Before those go on, I want to do everything I possibly can to the top. That means I want to cut the sound hole and the channel for the rosette. I want to get the rosette in, which means I have to, one, decide what rosette I want. Two, get a method to cut that rosette channel, which at the moment my Bosch Colt doesn't have a circle cutting jig. So we're kind of a little bit stalled on this bit at the moment until I can work that bit out. The other piece is bending the sides. After this part's done and putting the back together and all that stuff, the next step will be to bend the sides. I need to be able to bend the sides, so I've got to work that little bit up too. So we're at a point where I'm going to have to make some jigs. And I'm going to have to do that instead of build guitar stuff, but this is how it goes. We got to make the jigs. So I just figured I'd mention that and tell you that bracing is basically as far as I can take it until it's glued onto the front and back, on the top and back. So until then, bracing is going to take a little bit of a break. And we will come back to that after. So I'm going to mark some things out so that they go in the right places again here. Hold on a second. This one's here. This one was there. This one was there. We're going to put, I'm going to make some marks so I can reassemble this, put these away, and get set up to start building a couple of jigs. First is going to be a circle cutting jig for the Bosch Colt, probably. And then I've got a bending jig I need to work out for bending the sides. I've still got some parts coming for that. So, anyways, bracing has come out pretty good for now. We've got it as far as I can take it. I'll bring you back when we're ready for the next step.